Friends, it is truly apparent the stock from which Lili is formed is evident. And it is an honor to recognize the 2018 United States Hispanic Chamber of Commerce Hispanic Businessperson of the Year, a modern gladiator, a pure faith warrior, devoted mother, wife, and a heck of a business person, Lili Gil Valletta.
Here we are. Of course, America has changed quite a bit. And it's changing because of all of us and the faces and the stories that we all represent. And I think Mark, who is a dear friend and he did such an amazing job, I need to take him around with me. He was sharing my journey as a proud Colombian immigrant. But what you may not know is when I got here and left my entire family behind, I couldn't speak a word of English. Had a suitcase, a student visa, and a pocket translator. Because, yes, I'm that old. And who would have thought that that experience I had as a young immigrant, when people in the early 90s heard I was from Colombia, all they could think of was Pablo Escobar, right? Now I have to explain myself all over again, thanks to Netflix. But that was 30 years ago, and people, please travel to Colombia, it's very nice. But that cultural misunderstanding actually became a muse and a thing in my heart that really carried me all the way through my corporate career and today my life as an entrepreneur. So I guess my invitation to you all is to really search for what is that thing that really moves your heart beyond the desire of our words, money, or title. Because all that stuff comes and goes. But it is ultimately our faith and our strength coming from something greater than ourselves that keeps us going when things are really tough. I'm reading Mark's notes that he left behind, and he called me a modern gladiator. What is that? You know what's really interesting? We get to fancy events like this and we celebrate the resume and all the cool facts that Mark shared. But what a lot of times we forget is that there is a whole journey of learnings and ups and downs and failures that really have shaped us into who we are today. About 3 years ago, we lost 60% of our revenues with two phone calls because two clients were going through an M&A. Things happen in Wall Street. And a lot of businesses like ours face the reality of potentially going out of business. And it was that moment that created this burning desire in our team to innovate and bet on technology and graduate from being a service to becoming a tech firm and a product, and today we are looking to triple our size in 2019. Yeah. Yeah. That happens when something bigger than money and title moves your heart. And we believe, we truly believe at CIEN Plus and CulturIntel that it is mathematically impossible for any company in America to achieve its full potential in growth and in business without cultural intelligence into everything they do. It's mathematically impossible. Yes, you can clap for that. Because when we look at the numbers and we look at the trends and the value that we each represent, as corporate leaders too, because the numbers that you represent as professionals in the places and the privileged boardrooms that you get to sit on, as well as us as entrepreneurs, is what we need to keep America going. The U.S. Hispanic Chamber of Commerce has an impact that is much greater than this room. If it's mathematically impossible for businesses to grow, it is also mathematically impossible for America to prosper and achieve its full potential without the segment that is driving the most contributions in growth, size, population, buying power, voting power, etc., etc. So my invitation to you all is you can either go back out of these doors, return to your normal everyday jobs, running your businesses, you know, advocating for our community and everything else, or stop to realize that just the fact that we're here and understand the power we represent in numbers gives you already a competitive edge versus most people out there. There is cultural intelligence in everyone in this room, and that is your superpower. But it cannot be executed or come to life without you choosing to bring it to life. Because it takes one of us in the room to actually ask the hard question and bring the power of numbers to the table when you're making a budget decision, when you're looking at a plan or a product or a service innovation or a new go-to-market strategy. So there you go. My MO these days, powered by AI and all this cool tech stuff that we're doing with our company clients, is anchored in one very simple fact. We're not only powerful because we have the superpower of cultural intelligence, but of course, in God we trust. Everyone else, bring me the data. Thank you.